All right, lads, welcome back to yet another podcast. As always, it's an honor and privilege to be here. My name's Connor. The man on my virtual left is Trevor. All right, getting into the podcast today, we got two special guests.
We're expecting one, but we got two, so that's nice.
Two for one, which is nice. I don't know about you, but like I've been on an absolute grind the last 2 days. I don't know what's going on with me, but like with the podcast, with school, it's just been like a crazy. Oh, by the way, I also won for the first time in gambling yesterday. Well, I know, right? I know. It's a monument. I took a picture of the ticket and everything. It was beautiful. $29. And the funny thing is this was my sixth time gambling. So I actually, and I only bet like $5 each time. So I actually ended up spending $30 and only winning $29.
So you but made it's still $1. Not
bad. It's progress.
You lost a dollar. But so, I mean, it's not the end of the world.
Me being the responsible man that I am, I decided to spend $10 today on gambling again. So you know what? We'll see what happens, but fingers crossed. We'll see what happens. Anyways, our two special guests today, both are playing Junior A for the French River Rapids of the Northern Ontario Junior Hockey League, better known as the NOJHL. Both played AAA for a number of years.
Give me a sec.
What do you mean? We got Jack Ginocchi and Cole Sheffield coming on. Jack actually got drafted by the Niagara Ice Dogs of the OHL. And they're both currently playing for the French River Rapids Junior A of the Northern Ontario Junior Hockey League, also known as the NOJHL.
Now, do they play in the real Junior A?
Or they're the real team. It's the real
team. So they're better than you.
Okay, you know what? I'm not going to get into this. I promise you. It says Junior A on the sweater. It says Junior A on the website. It's Junior A.
Are you wearing, Connor?
Yeah, of course.
Like this. I have to say that might be.
What does that say?
Don't even lie. That is an ugly logo.
No. Okay, look.
They could do a lot better things with that logo.
I feel like they could have as well. But you know what?
They could. I like the color scheme. It's kind of like the Predators, but that is just an ugly sweater. Like,
it's not that ugly. It's just like a nice navy blue.
It's so ugly. It's so logos aren't supposed to be very detailed, I feel, and that is so.
I like that. I think if they just took out the Predators and just had the bird, I feel like
it's the bird that's the problem. I don't like the bird.
But it's so detailed. Like it's a nice bird.
That's the problem. I don't like it.
Okay. Well, anyways, moving on.
That's a tough look for another day.
Also, I should say. I don't know what's going on. I've kind of been going crazy the last couple of days. I lost my hat. So now I got to wear this pink one.
It's on your head.
Like a tooth fairy right now, but
I mean,
you know what? It's a grind day in, day out. Anyways,
you didn't have to wear a hat.
Yeah, I guess I didn't, but still, you know, it makes me look. Anyways,
it doesn't actually.
Anyways, let's get into this podcast. Joining us now via Zoom, we have Cole and Jack. How's it going, guys? Thanks for coming on.
Thanks for having us.
All right. So, again, obviously you two played, well, I guess you are still playing in French River this year. I guess, can you...
playing right now, but...
Yeah, obviously with COVID and everything and the restrictions, but can you just kind of talk to us for a second, just kind of about, I guess, what the restrictions were like playing? Because I know you guys kind of had somewhat of a season, I don't know what you want to call it, but...
We had a six-game season so far with a couple exhibitions, but it was weird. No contact hockey is weird, man. Going back from a visor to a fishbowl, it's weird, man. Everything you have to do from a certain age growing up, they like forget it, go back to even before that minor hockey. It's crazy right now.
Yeah, and then for me, like being a goalie, like there's no hitting, right? So if you do happen to take a penalty, there's a lot more penalties during games, so definitely a lot more killing to do. So it was a little tougher, but it's been good so far.
Yeah, not to mention you get a penalty boxing a guy out in front of the net. Mm-hmm. You literally no contact. They blow a puck down. If you like kill a puck in the boards, blow it down instantly.
Really?
No boxing ball.
Yeah.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah, no, it's, I can't really speak for everybody, but I guess everyone's kind of making sacrifices. I know you guys, if I'm not mistaken, you guys were the only league that actually, like, played some games, right? Because most leagues are pretty well out for now, right?
I think it's only the Maritime League that's playing right now, other than us, in the CJL. Yeah. So, yeah, we were the only league that was, like, going to go, or the SI maybe, too.
Yeah, I think they played a few exhibition games,
but everything's just getting canceled, especially with all the lockdowns. Just, they keep getting extended.
Yeah, so, no, I know. It's. I think we got, at least another 3-4 weeks before anything is going to change.
Yeah.
But
yeah, exactly.
Yeah, yeah. So, but I guess the other thing I was kind of curious about, so obviously you guys right now, are you guys like living in French River right now, or like what's kind of the situation? Yep.
So we're in French River quarantining right now. We like us, we live in the same house. Yeah. Bunch of other guys, we live with 4 other guys on the team, but for the most part, our guys are up here. We're quarantining, still working out, getting on the pond, but like we don't have access to any of our equipment, like our change room. We can't go on the ice at all, so it's still weird. We don't know what's happening.
And you guys, like, you guys can see your other teammates, though, right?
Yeah, that we can do.
So, because that's one thing good about living up here. Like, we're not totally locked down. We're kind of locked down as a team, so we do have people to see. So a little bit better than being at home. So.
And there hasn't been a new case here yet, so not really much worries in our community, but.
Yeah, because we were talking to like other people and they all have to quarantine by themselves. So I guess like quarantining as a team kind of like makes your chemistry on like on the ice, kind of off the ice, a lot better. So yeah, it's good that you guys are all together.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'd be hard not to be though, living in a town like this. Small town, you'd go crazy. It's great to be
always. Very small, yeah.
Yeah. So again, you guys so right now you guys, again, are quarantining for what, another 28 days? Do you think there's going to be a season? Do you think you guys are going to be able to practice again as a team? Like, what's kind of the feeling here?
Okay. So like as much as you want to be optimistic, I'm going to say right now it's starting to look a lot less and less like we're going to continue.
Yeah.
Starting to look, we're just going to call it what it is. Just those 6 games or whatever, and that's the rest of it. There's teams dropping out of our league already, like Hurston Timmins. Mm-hmm. So I personally don't think we're going to play. We practice after the lockdown's over, but I don't think the league will run again. It might, though.
Yeah, I agree. Like, kind of just a waiting game at this point. It has been most of the season, but kind of just waiting to hear from the league officials about – an official start date, and then if there is one, if it's going to get pushed back again. So,
right. And who we'd be
in. Yeah, that's another big thing.
Yeah, sorry. What we forgot to mention with the new seasons, what we've been doing is our first 6 games, they were all against Espanola Express. So you play a team for like 2 weeks straight, and then you quarantine for 2 weeks, and then you play another team. So that you just keep – it's like playoff series over and over. Yeah. It's awful. It's like – it's tough to do, especially because you build up such a rivalry. Like, they get the game.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. That'd be tough. I mean, like, I obviously playing it, like, something's better than nothing at this point, right? But
exactly.
Yeah.
Connor, we play on, like, Beresford ice, which is literally just grass.
Yeah.
So at least you guys are in a rink. We're playing on grass right now.
That's brutal. Wow.
Yeah, no, it's again, everyone's trying to get something going, but it seems like every time you start, it's stopped like a week later, right? It's I don't know, it's hard, but so you guys were saying, right? You guys have I guess so you're playing like 2 weeks against each team. Are you guys, like, is there any team rules as far as, like, protocol? Like, let's say, I don't know, is there, like, a curfew or something like that to kind of make sure everyone's somewhat staying safe and, you know, you don't have guys going off wherever?
Oh, yeah. Well, we have a team Snapchat group chat so our coach can keep track of us on Snap Maps. Because, like, Sudbury has COVID cases, so they don't want us going to Sudbury this year. And a lot, like – you know, we're young guys. A lot of us kept bored in French River, and sometimes you want to go to Sudbury. So sometimes guys are sneaking off. So he kept us on team snap maps so we could you keep us more under control.
Yeah.
Nice, nice. I love it.
I guess anything to play, man.
Exactly.
Like COVID jeopardized the whole league. So.
So. Is there, like, right now as it stands, obviously, I know it has to be hard for you guys. I mean, I guess it's hard for everybody, but is there kind of a rough plan as to what you guys are doing next year? Are you guys going to plan on staying in French River and maybe playing next season? Or, like, what's the plan here for his future?
Yeah, I hope we're playing next season.
For sure.
The only thing I could care less where I'm playing, hopefully it's with the boys back in French River, but – as long as I'm playing hockey next year, man, I'd be happy.
Yeah,
I agree. Staying in the CJ would be great. Just kind of waiting and hoping to have games coming up in September. But, again, it's just kind of like a waiting game. And, yeah, it'd be great to be back here with everyone.
Yeah, I know it's hard. I mean, I know, especially for my team, right? I mean, I haven't seen any guys on my team in like 4 months now. So again, as you said, I'm assuming like probably if you guys do have any games, do you think it's going to kind of be the same thing? Like, is it going to be the 2 weeks and you pretty well? Yeah.
Like before season got postponed again because of the lockdown, we were supposed to be going head to head with Blind River for another series, but who knows now?
Yeah, before Christmas break, too, they're actually talking about pushing into 1 week just because we were behind a little bit, and we're supposed to be playing, like, 5-6 series a year. So, yeah, I think if we do end up playing again, it'll be, what, 2 weeks again?
Yeah.
6 games in 2 weeks. So we play twice every weekend, which is nice. But
sometimes 3 a weekend.
Yeah.
No, not even anymore this year. Have you had a 3 weekend this year?
Not yet, no.
No. They want to go to 3 games a week. It was like a Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and then your weekend off to practice. It'll be weird if we resume, though. Like, more games than practices
busy.
A week.
Yeah, it'll be busy.
So I know, again, like, before Christmas, you guys also had a couple certain teams, I guess, were allowed fans, right? I think it was up to, like, 50 fans. What was that like? Was it kind of weird, I guess, like, seeing people with masks on and all that crap, or...?
It was weird not having like everyone there. Usually the rink is just alive. You've got fans everywhere in the bar, like in the stands, out front by like the food bar, snack bar. But it's quiet. It's empty. It feels like it's back in minor hockey again. That's the best way I could put it. I feel like I'm playing minor hockey again.
Yeah, we're in a big hockey town too, and then half of the 50s are parents and like friends and family and stuff. So. There's like only 20 tickets, I would say, for sale within the community, and they sell out really quick. So,
So
yeah, it's gotta suck.
Again, everyone's making sacrifices, but I guess kind of one of the following up here. So I know both you guys are like billeting, right? Now in French River. I just kind of want to get a sense, like, why French River over, maybe like the Ontario Junior Hockey League or like other kind of leagues like that. Like, why'd you guys want to go up there instead of other leagues, I guess?
Well, for me, I had a spot last year at 17 in the CJ. I didn't know much about like the league really. And I practiced with the team, then went to one of their camps. And I just really liked what I saw. Like, I knew they had a good program. Knew they moved a guy, Phil Doe, up to the Moncton Wildcats, who just got drafted to the show this year by Ottawa. So they've had another 16-year-old who has games in the O, or who had games in the O at 16. Yeah. Ryan Smith has games in the O. Like, it's a good league. So a lot of people don't understand that this is actually a serious junior A hockey league. It's just we don't have as much exposure as other leagues.
Right.
So I was more happy to cut 1-4 as like a defenseman playing that role rather than a 5-6 team. So
Right.
Yeah, I would say for me, coming out of minor midget last year, like, there's definitely a lot of options, like major midget and other things, but I was looking to make the jump to junior hockey, and luckily our coach was welcoming enough to have me, and I'm glad he did, because so far it's been great. And then first coming here, like, really welcomed by all the guys, and yeah, it's pretty hard to make a junior league at 16, but again, like I said, our coach, very, very happy that he accepted me.
Right. So how many actual teams are in your league, right? Like, I guess, originally before the season started?
12 teams.
So it's 12
teams. We are in a smaller league, but we're not – it's not like the SI where it's six teams or whatever. It's,
right, right. So how many teams are roughly, like, if – again, as if it's all up in the air, but if there is a season, how many teams are, like, good to go now?
Six, maybe.
Yeah, six or eight.
No less. Not eight. Bruce Timmons, Paulson, that's three out. Elliot Lake, so eight.
Mm-hmm. Right now, that's it, I think.
Is anyone else out?
I don't think, but there definitely could be guys.
Or there's teams that don't have their teams up yet, but...
Yeah, that's true.
They just have their guys at home. So it's weird. I actually don't know. It's probably about 6 to 8, actually. Yeah.
Around there.
Huh. Wow, that's a weird. Big drop-off, eh? Huge.
Yeah.
But is there, like, I didn't really know much about the Northern Ontario Junior Hockey League. But is there a lot of, like, imports, or, like, is it mostly guys from Ontario or maybe Quebec or something?
Usually guys from Ontario.
Yeah. Okay.
This year's the first year we have not had an American player on the French River Rapids in their, like, existence. So usually, for the most part, we've got imports coming in. A lot of times it's Sudbury guys. Guys who are drafted by the Wolves will come play here because we're affiliates with them. Oh, three guys, Marshall Frappier as well.
Yeah, there's been a couple.
Yeah, so most of our players are usually either, like, Sudbury draft picks or Southern Ontario junior guys just wanting to come play.
Hmm. Cool. Well, I think we pretty well covered everything. Now, we do kind of this tradition on the podcast. Well, actually, we forgot to do it last week, but we're trying to keep this tradition up. We need your take on it. Who's better, LeBron or Jordan?
Oh, wow.
I'm saying Jordan.
There we go.
I'm saying Jordan as well. I'm kind of... Watch The Last Dance or whatever it's called
exactly,
on Netflix.
Exactly.
You got to watch it, man. Change your perspective. That guy thinks like a winner. That guy thinks
Sorry,
different.
Sorry, no. Just the stats aren't there. LeBron is bigger. No, it's fine. You're the guest. It's fine.
Three on one, man. You're not winning this one. But anyways, no, guys, we really do appreciate you taking the time. Again, best of luck in the season, if there is a season. And hopefully we can do this again down the road.
Yeah, thank you
for having us.
Yeah, no worries, man. All right. So that wraps up another podcast. As always, you can find us on Instagram and YouTube at The Lawn Chair Lads. Yeah, we'll see you next time. I'm in the field for real. I'm about my check.